Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm thrilled to be sharing my Uromastix enclosure. My Uromastix Wren has been here for 2 months now, and I've made some slight changes to her enclosure throughout the time of her being here, so I feel confident in sharing that enclosure now that she's like really settled into it and really enjoying it. Before we get started, I'd like to say that I have an affiliate link with Zen Habitats, who is the company that manufactured the enclosure that she's in. If you are interested in getting a Zen Habitats for yourself, I will leave my affiliate link down below. It doesn't cost you anything extra, and it does give me a small commission, so I'm eternally grateful to everyone who has helped me get through 2020 by supporting my affiliate link, so thank you very much, I appreciate you. But now let's go ahead and get started. Oh wait! Please like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and now we can go ahead and get started. So if you're not a fan of Attack on Titan, you might not recognize like what I was doing there, but it's because I'm wearing the Scout Regiment cloak. Anyways, moving on. This is me taking off the doors to the 4x2x2 Zen Habitats enclosure. One thing I really love about this enclosure is that the doors do come off so easily and give you great access to the enclosure. However, I must say that Wren went absolutely wild her first couple weeks here doing a lot of glass surfing, and she scratched up her doors, so I'll be having to get more because, I mean, she really did a number on them. But this is the interior of her enclosure. It features driftwood, it features really heavy, large rocks, it features substrate, which we'll get into in a minute, it features some faux succulents. It is as naturalistic as possible without being like live planted bioactive. Now, you will not be seeing Wren throughout this video because she just hides whenever I come near her enclosure and mess with it. Like, if I'm standing outside the enclosure, she's fine, but if I get into the enclosure, she's like, no, thank you, and she hides underneath her favorite rock, which she has a lot of entry and exit points from. She has this one on the side, on the front, and then she has one in the back as well. She absolutely loves this rock, and she has dug all the substrate out from underneath of it. This back corner has a lot of substrate. It can be really hard to tell because it like blends in with the corner rock. But if you look at the video I posted about her enclosure before I got her, you can see the difference in how much substrate there is. There's also a difference in the type of wood that I'm using. So now I have different wood, whereas before I had manzanita. The current wood is grapevine logs, and I'll leave links to everything down below. So Wren has two sources of heat as well as UVB. She has a deep heat projector and a halogen bulb, both on dimmers by Arcadia. And then she also has her Arcadia T5HO 12% UVB bulb. It looks like it's running the whole length of the enclosure, but it's not. It's just the angle of this photo. When you use UVB, it's only supposed to take up 1/2 to 3/4 of the length of the enclosure. So keep that in mind. The substrate that I'm using is a combination of washed and sifted play sand mixed with Josh's Frog's Bio Arid. I also recommend just using organic topsoil mixed with washed play sand. So Wren's enclosure sits on top of Nova's enclosure. In order to do that, you buy Zen Habitat stacking spacers. And to offer more support to Wren's enclosure, I actually bought another set and then I put them along the middle. So as you can see, there's 3 bars that are supporting the bottom of the enclosure just because the rocks are so heavy and it's good to have extra support. I also wanted to include a clip of Wren eating. As you can see before, she was like hiding. She's like, oh, maybe I'll come out. It took her like a solid 5 minutes and I just had to let the phone sit there on a tripod and walk away. But she did come out and she was like, oh, okay. She's not around anymore. It's safe to eat. I did speed the clip up a little bit just so that you're not watching her eat for like 10 minutes straight. I mean, if you're into that type of content, let me know and I can do that for you. But just for the purpose of this video not being too long, I did speed it up. So Wren is currently eating turnip greens and escarole out of a little ceramic dish. The ceramic dish is not actually advertised for reptiles. I bought it. It was like a food grade human one. And a lot of times they're cheaper because when something is advertised for pets, it's like a markup, which I think is ridiculous. So I was like, these bowls are cute and simple and they come in a 6-pack, and I needed a few of them for my bearded dragon enclosures and for my blue tongue skink as well. So I was like, let me just get this. And it's worked out really well. She just kind of perches at the edge of it and eats out of it as she would any other dish. I also want to add that although Wren is eating escarole and turnip greens today, that is not something that she eats every single day. I really do try to give a variety of greens to my bearded dragons and to Wren and also to Haku, the blue tongue skink as well. Offering a variety is the best thing you can do for your reptiles because everything offers different amounts of nutrients. I actually went over this in my bearded dragon care video that I'm currently editing. It's over 2 hours long, so it's just a blast. It's a lot of fun to edit. But I just wanted to say, as like a normal disclaimer, that just because she's eating this in this video doesn't mean that's all she ever eats. For the most part, ever since coming home, Ren has been really great about eating. There was like a 2-week period where she wasn't eating her greens as often as she had been before, but she got over that. I'm not sure if that was just because I had changed out the wood in her enclosure and she was like, I don't think so, lady. I'm mad that you keep putting your hands in my enclosure, so I'm gonna stop eating my greens. Or if she was just still settling in or whatever, but she's completely normal now, eats every single day that I offer food. She's just really great. Aside from a care video, please let me know what types of videos you'd like to see about my Uromastix Ren, and I'll try to make them for you guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed seeing Ren's enclosure. If you did, let me know by leaving a like, a comment. Also, please subscribe, hit that notification bell. Please don't forget to check out the links below, including the Zen Habitats link, which they have enclosures for all kinds of sizes of reptiles, so I'm sure you'll find whatever you need there. Again, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!